Thanks for sitting down with me today. I appreciate it.
Great day, great afternoon. I appreciate it.
Andy, we're sitting here in Chicago. A record attendance again. We're somewhere near around 3,000 folks coming in this year. Congratulations. A great event. As we look forward into 2015, what's the number one takeaway that you take away from this conference?
Well, there's a lot going on in the industry right now, Sean, with the market coming down and these crops and people looking at what are the prices going to look like for seed. You got a lot of seed companies that are very active with their growers right now, trying to make sure that they have the products that they want for their planting the next year. But also as we look at new technologies, whether it's seed treatments or breeding techniques, just a lot of issues really popping, and I think that's why we see the attendance right at or above 3,000.
Which is great news for everybody.
It really is. It's nice to see the interaction. Most of our meeting rooms have been packed full. We've been bringing chairs in and a lot of discussion on topics that this industry has to drive.
In June, you folks elected new leadership into ASTA.
Yes.
As always, you elected Risa into a position of first vice chair, first woman into that position.
Correct.
Yeah, which is great. Why is that important for the association, and where do you see that growing towards? Yeah.
Well, I think Risa is a great leader in the industry, and the issue really in her election, as everybody realized, was that her talents that she brings to the table. It obviously is a huge plus for us as a female in the industry and a leader in this industry, but she's such a strong personality with respect to having that presence and the importance of the industry and driving it. So I guess we see it as a very, very talented seeds woman taking that position and moving into the chair next year, and we look forward to her taking that role.
Awesome. AST reminded farmers recently about the importance and precautions of making sure that we're handling treated seed properly.
Correct.
Can you talk a little bit about that campaign, where it got to, and maybe where some of the successes or the failures came along?
Well, we started this campaign a little over 2 years ago with Crop Life America and the grower organizations like Farm Bureau and Corn Growers and Soybean Association, Cotton. And it really has been a success. And I would say the success is that EPA likes what we're doing. And we brief them all the time on how many outreach efforts we've had and how many interactions or presentations to growers we've made. We think it helps to raise that awareness for growers. And we've recently revised the seed treatment guide, and it'll be out in January. And we'll be back out talking to the growers again through the winter and their winter meetings.
Right. You've had a chance to bring together your committees here in Chicago. Lots of great dialogue, lots of great attendance. Can you pluck off something that's a key feature that you've heard as you've gone through that process?
Yeah, one of the key things is everyone is really pleased that ASTA's taken a lot of proactive steps and movements to influence policy or influence positions within the industry. And one thing that we'll be seeing here soon, Sean, is our effort to improve the communications about the seed industry, who we are and why we do what we do. And we're really excited about this new campaign.
And we've also expanded the reach. We're getting this information into some bigger audiences, some significant audiences. Success stories there? Good pieces?
Yeah, really good pieces. As we did some analysis, what we were looking to do is to go from that talking to the grower, who is our customer, to standing shoulder to shoulder with that grower to talk to the consumer and really talking about the seed industry. And the positives that we saw in that is really the strong support for seed innovation in the consumer community. We'll be talking to moms, we'll be talking to millennials, and we'll be talking to foodies in the future.
Nice. So as we look into the 2015 and for the future of the seed industry in the U.S. and globally, which obviously you're playing a role in, what do you see as some of the challenges that we're going to face for this coming year?
Well, we'll continue to see some pressure on the market just because of where we are with row crops and pricing. But I think globally we see some challenges in some markets that don't quite have sound seed systems, whether it's approval of biotech traits or just protection of intellectual property as seed companies look to partner to develop varieties that are more appropriate for certain marketplaces. And so those are challenges for us, but also opportunities to go out and talk to other governments and our government talking to theirs.
And then the next piece to that is, if we look back at 2014, where has ASTA really moved the needle? Where do you see some real success pieces?
I think we moved the needle just on awareness of the industry. We spent a lot of time this year, as you know, in outreaching to not just our friends in the ag media, but our friends in the media.
Right.
We saw a lot of that here this week, and we were really excited about being able to tell a story. And we have some key tools and innovation in this industry, and we're very confident in biotech and others. But we also realize that seed is the foundation for all plant agriculture. And we're excited about telling that story. And people have picked it up and really enjoy telling it and passing it on for us.
Nice. Perfectly well said, Andy. Thanks again for sitting down with me. I appreciate it.
Oh, no problem, Sean. Glad to have you here.